Okay, hello everyone. My name is Piotr Perucki. I'm here today to present you how to unleash the power of Intel GPU and tell you a few words how Intel supports game developers like you to unleash the power of Intel GPU. A few words about me. I'm graphics software engineer at Intel Technology Poland. I'm working there for almost 4 years now. My job consists of games and benchmarks performance analysis. My main focus is on DirectX API. I provide game developers with feedback regarding what can be improved to increase the performance of their games. And the goal is to obviously bring the best experience on Intel hardware. Okay, now I would like to ask a few questions to get to know a little better you. So how many of you have ever developed any game? Please raise your hands. Okay, are you a game programmer? Okay, do we have any artist? That's nice. Do you use your own developed engine? Or do you use engine like Unity, CryEngine, something like this? Okay, thank you so much. So, this talk is mainly focused on game programmers and game artists. In general, anyone who ever developed game or have any experience with 3D graphics would benefit from this talk. And obviously, if you would like to learn about performance optimization, mostly for Intel GPU, you're welcome to this talk. So, why should you care about Intel GPU? Do you know the statistics? Can anyone answer my question? How many do you think percentage of GPU market does Intel takes? Is it 10%, 20? Do you know? Okay, so about, according to statistics, it's about almost 70% of GPU market that Intel takes, Intel GPU takes. This is because most of the Intel processors have GPU integrated. So according to Steam statistics and Steam surveys and Unity statistics, it's about from 13 to 16% of players equipped with Intel hardware, GPU. That's quite a lot. And that's why we recommend you to take your time and optimize your game for Intel platform. Okay, have you ever heard about Intel Game Developer Program? Okay, that's great. So Intel Game Developer Program gives you access to many libraries, tools for performance optimization of your game. You can find on this, under this link, lots of code samples, game developer guides, how to optimize your game to run smoothly on Intel hardware. Also, you can find some good answers and get inspiration on our developer forum. In today's presentation, I will mostly focus on performance analysis and tool usage for 3D app performance. So, to begin with, have you ever used Intel GPA? Have anyone heard about this tool? Okay, I see a few people. So, basically, this is a suite of tools that allows you to find performance bottlenecks within your application. Our experience shows that if you spend time optimizing your, to take time to fully understand how your game is executing code, it will definitely pay off. you will see opportunities in your application resulting in increase of performance measured by FPS. So who would like to see improvements of those performance as those on the screen, like from 5 to 30 FPS? That would be cool. Intel GPA runs on most popular platforms like Windows, Ubuntu, and Android. You can analyze your DirectX, OpenGL application on Intel hardware. Also, it will work on NVIDIA and AMD GPUs. But to take the full advantage of its potential, we obviously recommend you to run it on Intel platform. And how easy is GPA to use? It turned out very easy. There is no requirement of code changes, no filling your code with instrumentation macro, no recompiles of your code. Just simply run our tool on your game and have fun optimizing your application. So now let's meet our analyzers. Graphics monitor is the tool used to launch your application. It can handle even complex mechanisms like Steam or Origin. The powerful feature of this tool is that you can set up frame triggers. Like, for example, your game is running 30 FPS or 60, and suddenly you see a drop of performance to like 5 FPS, then it could be hard sometimes to capture single frame by hand for offline analysis what was happening. So this tool allows you to set up those triggers, and whenever the FPS drops, you'll have this frame for further analysis. System Analyzer is one of the first tools you're likely to use. It allows you to connect to your application and gather real-time information about your application. You will see highly detailed CPU and GPU metrics, also power metrics and lots of other platform data, all in real time. The real-time graphs help you see whether or not there are some activity spikes, or whether or not you are CPU or GPU bound. Those CPU and GPU metrics are based on our internal hardware metrics, counters. Analyzing your application on Intel CPU and GPU gives you access to those highly detailed metrics. Another powerful feature of this tool is ability to run real-time experiments. You can, for example, turn off some draw calls, disable depth testings, exchange pixel shaders with simple ones to see whether or not you are GPU or CPU bound. And this allows you to quickly see lots of most commonly appearing problems. Platform Analyzer is our next tool in this suite. It's used for monitoring both CPU and GPU activity at the same time. This tool helps you figure out how efficiently you're using CPU and GPU resources. It's often early in development that we have unbalanced workload. For example, sometimes our CPU is completely busy, but our GPU is idle. And this tool quickly shows you that information. And my favorite tool in this suite, Frame Analyzer. If you discover that you are GPU bound, this is where you can do deep dive into what's happening inside any frame you capture. This tool can quickly tell you where your performance bottlenecks are. You can expect any texture, shader, geometry, actually any resource within one specific frame from your game. And also you can carry out some experiments, offline experiments. You can actually change any states within single frame and quickly see performance deltas to see if the performance increased or not. All without need for changes in your code of your game. So this is quite good tool to use. Actually, I had fun because whenever I played some famous games like Call of Duty, Battlefield, I can actually do it on my own in home to capture one frame and analyze how they done something in this game. This is like cool. So you can obviously benefit from it. Okay, now get back to performance analysis. So approaching to analysis, the first step is to determine whether performance issues are caused by CPU or GPU. Understanding performance and at this level is extremely important because otherwise you may spend a lot of time optimizing parts of your game that end up being insignificant. In a CPU-bound application, is the GPU that waits for completion of works happening on CPU, and if the GPU finishes before CPU can provide more work, the GPU is idle, so we don't use the full performance ability of GPU. In GPU-bound application, this is CPU threads waiting for completion of work happening on GPU. The problem may lie, for example, in memory throughput. So we are accessing lots of data, for example, or we use very detailed textures within our game. We can have problem on the CPU-GPU synchronization. This often happens whenever we have like VSync turn on or some our own synchronization happening that could be postponed for the later stages of the game. And also on some low power devices, we can become TDP bound, power bound. So the power needs to be balanced between CPU and GPU, and it may cause performance degradation. Okay, so we have our game and we run system analyzer to collect platform data like GPU busy, CPU utilization. We measure FPS overriding some states and decide whether we are CPU or GPU bound. If you are GPU bound, we capture a frame for offline analysis and we can do deep dive into what's happening within one single frame. If we are CPU limited, we capture trace and use platform analyzer to see what's the problem on the CPU side. Okay, so if you are CPU bound, then the cause of the performance degradation may be because of your application code, some libraries. Sometimes it happens that it's a driver problem, of course. And to deal with it, I recommend you to use VTune application. It allows you to do code profiling. Okay, now a few words about GPU pipeline. This is how the latest generation of Intel processor looks like. It actually, one third of the surface is taken by the GPU. It's quite a lot. And this is how the GPU pipeline flow looks like. You have those arrows indicates the flow of the data from the input, where we have geometry, shaders, and resources. And at the end, we have our data written to memory. This is the final image output. And actually, any of these stages can become a bottleneck. So we, at any of those stages, we can have performance problem because of, for example, high textures, highly detailed textures, and sampling of those. We have become, there can be a problem at accessing the memory because of poor pattern, and we actually can hurt the memory throughput. So basically, we have introduced a methodology of performance analysis. There is a specific way to look for performance bottlenecks defined by this graph. And what it means, we go from the top of this graph to the bottom, looking for checking if any of the stage is may have a given bottleneck. If not, we move forward. If yes, we can stop and start working on improving it. But as you can see, those stages are written in reverse order comparing to execution flow. This is because, for example, whenever we are bound on the last stage, for example, writing data to memory, this stall actually may propagate to the earlier stages, and we can have could incorrectly decide that we have problem, for example, with geometry. But actually, the problem may be at writing the finite data to memory. So, this methodology is based on looking for hotspots with use of metrics available in GPA tool. Basically, this is the screenshot from Frame Analyzer. As you may suspect, red color indicates that there is some notification of geometry transformation being a bottleneck in this example. Each hotspot is defined by a set of metrics. For example, if we have more data requests to sampler than this unit is able to provide, then the problem may be in this unit. Okay, case study number one. We have some frame that I have analyzed recently, and we see that there is some draw call that takes lot of time executing. This draw call output is terrain, in-game terrain rendering. It takes about 3.5 milliseconds, and 75% of this draw call is actually stalled, so the execution units waits for data. And as we can see, GPA tells us that this is because of the sampler unit. So what could be the reason for the sampler to become a bottleneck? For example, we sample highly detailed textures. In this case, it was texture of 1K by 1K. But that's not everything. We can carry out experiments and actually lower the resolution of this texture to the lower one and see if the performance improved. in this example, whenever I chose to lower the resolution to, it was 100 by 100, I suppose, then the time lowered to 2 milliseconds, and this is quite good improvement. The other problem that may be the cause of stall at sampler unit, maybe because of using this anisotropic filtering. This is good for visual quality, but actually causes the GPU to wait for data because of high sampler unit usage. And changing this to linear sampling filtering mode actually helped us and lowered the time of this draw call to 1 millisecond from 3.5. So it's quite a good improvement and indicates that this unit actually was the problem. So whenever you see performance degradation, you should consider like usage of lower resolution of textures first. In this example, like this. Okay, case study number two. Another frame from a game. We can see set of draw calls, and it takes about more than 6 milliseconds to execute those for the GPU, and more than half of the time the GPU execution units are idle. It's indicated by this gray color. And it seems that geometry transformation is the problem. So in this example, we can see that there is very big number of vertices sent to GPU. There is almost 800,000 of triangles sent to GPU, but only 40,000 pixel renders. So there is more triangles than pixel renders, and that obviously isn't efficient. And it seems like the game was trying to display highly detailed grass, like far, far away from the user screen. And obviously, whenever we advise the developer to lower the details of this geometry, we saw the performance improvements. But as you can see, it was indicated by this GPA tool very easily. Case study number three. So in this example, we can see that there is a problem in writing final data to memory. And one of the reasons is that we are using actually 4 render targets. So we are saving some properties of the image to 4 textures. One of the problem is that we are using, for example, one of the problem may be that we are using unsupported texture format that isn't like compressed very well on this hardware. You should check on for each hardware if this hardware supports compression of this texture, because if not, then we obviously can suffer from high memory usage and also memory throughput. The other problem at this example was that this shader actually was writing black color to one of the textures, indicated by the line 136. And also all the render targets were, the alpha channel were filled with 1, but actually earlier in the scene we could see that the textures were cleared with all 0s color. So whenever we advise the game developer to change the clear to the alpha color of cleaning to one and removing those writes in render target in the shader, we obviously increase the performance because of removing unnecessary saving data to memory. Okay, summary. Besides tool, Intel provides lots of developer guides, samples, and documents like those free available for you to download. You can find those under this link. And the second one is addressed to those willing to understand the architecture of Intel GPU. Inside, you will find overview how the graphics hardware works and how to take the best full advantage of it. And the first one guide is addressed for those who want to optimize your application. You will find lots of examples, like the ones that were introduced here today. How to optimize your application, how to optimize your DirectX code, also OpenGL code. And you'll find step-by-step instruction, how to write your game to make the full usage of, full power of Intel GPU. Okay, to sum up. First, try GPA, Intel GPA. It's a really great tool. I use this tool like almost every day at my work to help game developers optimize their games. You can download it for free from our site and have fun optimizing your application. Read, obviously, the guides that were introduced a slide ago. You'll find lots of tutorials, hints, how to optimize your application, how to make the full usage of Intel GPU potential. And of course, analyze performance and optimize your game. Your end users will definitely appreciate that. And you'll provide players with great performance, with great experience. And here are, once again, the links where you can download the great tool, GPA, Intel GPA, also those developer guides. And you can find more information and samples on our Intel Developer Zone site. Also, if you have questions, you can feel free to email me at any time. And thank you so much for your attendance.